this opportunity just to come before you once again, just to lift up your name and even to be a part of this class, Lord God, of what you're doing, of losing weight and loving life, Lord God, because we know that in Christ and through Christ we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us, even as you spoke on last night, Lord God, that we can do all things, but we can do nothing without you. So it's all or nothing, Lord God. So Lord, we just thank you, Lord God, that nothing is impossible with you, Lord, and that includes this weight loss journey that we're on, Lord. We know, as we always say, it's not a sprint, but it is a marathon, that if we just continue to take this thing one day at a time, we will reach our goal and we will be successful in that which God Almighty desires for our weight and for our health. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord God. Amen and amen. Come on and give God praise. Amen. And I just want to welcome all of you who are here to this Losing Weight and Loving Life class. And I want to welcome one of our newest members that came out today. Welcome, Mr. Daphne. It's great to have you with us. And I know you're gonna do well. You're going to do fantastic, because one thing about it, this is not a class that's about necessarily about weight loss in terms of every week, okay, how many pounds you lost or what have you. But it's a class that looks at the whole journey and the whole lifespan in the totality. In other words, when we say losing weight and loving life, what we're talking about lifestyle. We're talking about a whole new way of thinking and a whole new way of processing our food in terms of what we choose and what we do with our bodies. And that does not change overnight. It is a process, okay? So when you come to the class and you start, what you're doing is you're beginning your journey. You're beginning your journey to great health, your journey to weight loss. And so for that, you should just give yourself a hand, amen. And you know, as with any journey, you know that sometimes it takes a while before you're able to get to your destination. But getting to your destination, amen, when we're talking about losing weight and loving life, getting to your destination, which may be your goal weight, does not end your journey. Because your journey is going to be all the way through your lifespan. Whenever you're living a healthy life and you're not getting the diseases, and you know, you're able to do the things that God placed you here on earth to do with ease, and you're healthy. Because that's the main thing. I remember I asked you earlier, I said, well, what is your motivation? And you said health. And that's one of the best motivations. And yes, a byproduct of that is I'll look better, I'll feel better. But health is numero uno, because too many of us are dying with heart disease, diabetes, dying because of strokes, and so many diseases, even some cancers, are because of what? Because of the diet, what we eat, okay? So with that in mind, let's talk about what do we eat. If we're talking about a plan, and all of us, we're in the action stage right now. You even came in the action stage. You say, I'm ready, glory to God, I'm ready. So that's good that you're in the action stage. So when you're talking about the action stage, then that means that we're on a certain limited calorie intake per day on the action stage. Now, and that's what I don't want to confuse it up, because I know when we just started out and we was talking about the contemplation stage and preparation stage and then the action stage, before we get to the action stage, we talked about just certain things just to cut out of your eating plan per week and stop eating at a certain time. But when you move into the action stage, what you're saying is, okay, now I'm going to place myself on a certain caloric intake per day, okay? And what I'm recommending is between the 1,200 and 1,500 calories per day. And if you take that in, plus with your activity and your exercise, and you do that for the 7 days, then by the end of the week, you will have lost between 1 and 2 pounds. Okay, it's simple, it's biology, you know, it's nothing personal. if you do this, you're going to lose the weight. If you don't, then you're not going to lose. Okay? So it's just simple. It's biology. Okay? And so when we're talking about a 1,200, 1,500 calorie plan, then the first thing that we got to understand is that when we wake up in the morning, our body has been sleeping for how many of hours of sleep we've gotten, and we need fuel for the day. So saying I don't eat breakfast or I don't like breakfast and da-da-da, that's not gonna cut it if you really want to lose weight. As I always say, to lose weight is not about not eating. It's about eating to live and not living to eat. It's about what you eat, it's about when you eat, it's about how you eat, and it's even about why you eat. So when you get up in the morning, you want to give your body some fuel. You want to have breakfast. Don't tell me I didn't have time for breakfast. I wasn't hungry. You want to have breakfast when you get up in the morning. And that breakfast will consist of one starch. And it's usually, it'll come in the form of some oatmeal, or it'll come in the form of a whole wheat toast, a piece of whole wheat toast. Or maybe it'll come in the form of some whole grain cereal. Okay, with a half a cup of low-fat milk. Okay, so you will have that, and then you will have, so you got one starch, then you have one meat. Now the meat, eggs are considered meat, and you do need protein. Okay, so usually egg whites, you could have maybe two scrambled egg whites. Okay, or a lean, 1 to 2 pieces of lean turkey. Okay, so those are some examples of meat. Cottage cheese is also another example of meat. And then you want to have one fat. And the fat can be maybe a little margarine if you want to put it over your toast, or maybe a few almonds that you want to add to it there. So you got what? That's breakfast. What else can you add with that? You can add a piece of fruit with it if you like. Okay, so you eat that. Okay. Breakfast. What time you get up? Within 30 minutes of your getting up. When you first get up, the first thing you do is drink water. You drink that water, and so that you're starting to hydrate your body. Now I'm just telling you what to do if you really want to lose weight, right? Okay, so then after you do that, maybe 2 hours later, it's going to take you into your day, and you're going to want to have a snack. For those that like yogurt, eat some yogurt. You don't like yogurt, eat another piece of fruit. Maybe eat a small apple or orange or something like that. But just eat something. Why? Because that's helping to get your metabolism going. Okay? So then when it comes time for lunch, then what are you going to do? You're going to eat you one starch and one meat. And when I say that, and you're going to eat all of the vegetables that you want to eat. You can eat vegetables all day long. You can't eat fruit all day because fruit is high in sugar. It's also high in fiber. So then you want to go ahead and you want to eat your lunch. 2 hours later, you might want to have one of those 100 calorie snacks. Like you can get some 100 calorie popcorn or 100 calorie cookies or something like that, just to give you, you know, that taste or whatever. If you want that sweet, okay, that'll be your sweet. And that I would suggest that be your snack after lunch. And then it's time for dinner. So 2 to 3 hours later, it's time for dinner. So when you get your dinner, then what you're gonna eat? You're gonna eat one meat and one starch again. Just keep that in mind, and as many vegetables as you like. Drink water in between. And then you're gonna have one more snack before going to bed. And that snack that you have before going to bed should be something very low in sugar and low in fat. So you might eat something like a pickle, or, you know, something that's you know, raisins or something to that effect, or eat you some more vegetables. Drink you some water, go to sleep, and start over, and do it for 7 days. If you do that for 7 days, what I've just outlined, and you come in here and you have not lost between 1 and 2 pounds, then you can complain. But if you have not done that, and you come in here and you gain or you haven't lost, then just look at, okay, well, what do I need to do now to modify this so that I can begin the process of losing the weight? But listen, like I always say, we're not in a hurry, we're not in a race. Just by you showing up here is saying, okay, I'm in the game. I'm not, don't count me out. I'm in the game and I'm going to continue on until I get to that place that I know I can get to. And not only am I in the game, but I got God with me. And not only do I have the Lord with me, but I have this class and I have my coach that's here to help me to do this. Because I'm going to tell you something. If you don't know this, if you were not a part of this where you are aware and you're coming, it's no telling how big you'll be right now. You will definitely be bigger than you are, because at least you are aware of it and it's causing you to have some accountability. And I can say that because I remember when I wasn't living my life aware of what I was eating and how I was eating and what I was doing. And guess what? The scales got heavy. I gained and gained and gained. And, you know, my clothes and everything. Why? Because my body was just going on doing, you know, that, doing this thing. So just by you coming, it's stunting your fat growth. Okay? And that's one of the things that you want to do. So anytime you come here, even if you've lost a half a pound, that's celebration. That's celebration. You lost a pound. If you haven't gained, that's celebration. Because I guarantee you, if you wasn't coming, you would be gaining.